JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFT's daily market review for September the 29th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, head of research here at JFT, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded higher against all the other major currencies on Tuesday during the Asian session Wednesday. The currencies it outperformed the most are GBP, NZD and AUD, while it ecked out the least gains versus the euro. The rally of the US dollar across the board, especially against the commodity-linked currencies Aussie and Loonie, as well as against the pound, which has been acting as a risky asset lately, suggests that market sentiment deteriorated again yesterday. Indeed, turning our gaze to the equity world, we see that major global indices were a sea of red, tumbling on average nearly 2% as US Treasury yields kept marching north. The only exception was Hong Kong's Hang Seng, which is up 0.51%. Now, in our view, it was not just a single trigger that resulted in yesterday's bloodbath. It was a blend of ongoing developments. First of all, US Treasury yields may have kept rising on speculation that the surge in inflation is not as transitory as the Fed initially suggested, something that could lead to a November tapering move and earlier rate hikes after the program is ended, and that weighed on equities. Second, there is an ongoing battle in the US Congress, with Republicans appearing set to strike down Democrats' efforts to extend the government's borrowing authority and avoid a potential government shutdown. Third, we have the Evergrande saga, with the firm facing its next challenge today, as it is the deadline for another bond coupon payment to offshore investors. Another failure could revive fears that this could affect China's financial system and even have an impact to the rest of the world. Last but not least, widening power shortages in China have halted production in numerous factories. Moving ahead, we see decent chances for equities to extend their declines. Even if we see some small rebounds, we will treat them as corrective bounces. We believe that the aforementioned developments gave investors ample reasons to abandon stocks that were already considered overvalued. That said, we stick to our guns that when the sun shines again and all these problems are resolved, or let's say forgotten, equity indices, at least in the US, could rebound and march north despite the Fed keep withdrawing monetary policy support. All this may already be priced in by the current fall and any extensions of it. And after all, tightening policy means desired economic performance. In other words, we stay somewhat bearish in the short term, but we don't hold the same stance for the longer run. Actually, we are cautiously positive. In any case, we will take things step by step and reevaluate our outlook, our view when we judge necessary. As for today's events, as we noted yesterday, we have several central bank chiefs speaking at the ECB's forum on central banking, including ECB President Christine Lagarde, Fed Chair Powell, Bank of England Governor Andrew Bailey, and Bank of Japan Governor Haruhiko Kuroda. On top of that, it is the second day of the Fed Chair Powell's testimony. He will speak before the House Financial Services Committee. It would be interesting to hear what officials have to say will have to say about monetary policy and whether they will provide any clues or hints with regards to their future plans. During the Asian Day, we had the leadership election of Japan's ruling Liberal Democratic Party, with former Foreign Minister Fumio Kishida securing victory. Kishida will succeed Suga as Prime Minister, but he may not hold that position for long, as he must call an election by November 28th. As for the data, we have Germany's retail sales for August and the US pending home sales for the same month. Tonight, during the Asian session Thursday, Japan's preliminary industrial production and retail sales both for August are coming out. Industrial production is expected to have slid again, but at a slower pace than in July, while retail sales are forecast to have fallen 1% month over month after rising 2.4% the same month before. China's official PMIs for September are also due to be released, but we only have forecast for the manufacturing index, which is expected to have ticked up to 50.2. from 50.1. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT. Just fair and direct.